Listening to Radiolab.
I'm Craig Childs. I'm a writer and traveler from Western Colorado.
Craig likes to go hiking and exploring in the rough and rugged canyons of the Southwest, the ancient territory of the Anasazi.
But picture him just a few years ago standing in a reading room.
Nowhere near the canyons.
Right, in front of a display of ancient pottery.
Inside the cabinet is a collection of jars and bowls that are probably 700, 800 years old. And I recognize the design, and I know where they came from. I know that they came from a part of Arizona where I had just spent a month backpacking, and I had found the place just entirely looted.
Folks had come in and removed everything they could find.
Yeah. Some archaeologists, but mostly pot hunters, people illegally coming in and taking shovels and digging out burial artifacts. And these artifacts in this little cabinet were all stolen. They weren't cataloged, and in fact they were very roughly handled. Some had been broken and repaired with masking tape and
with
Elmer's
masking
glue.
Tape.
Yeah,
with Elmer's glue. And what did the sign say on the thing?
I think it just said, "These come from Arizona."
That was the extent of it.
Yeah.
So, what did you think, and then what did you do?
Well, I had been very frustrated at seeing this landscape that had been completely looted, and I thought, you know what, I need to take something back. And so I broke into the display case.
When did you do this, at night, or how did you get by the security?
I just did it when I kept an eye on the room and saw when nobody was in there. And
were you dressed in black and hanging from the ceiling?
I was looking like I look now.
How did you? Did you have a glass cutter?
I cut around the molding of the glass and removed the glass plate and reached in and took one of the jars that had been actually split in half with a shovel. I am not a good thief. I nearly pissed my pants in the middle of it, and then I rearranged all the jars and blew on the dust so it would resettle and look like nothing had ever changed.
And then?
And then I went down to the Apache Reservation, the White Mountain Apache Reservation in central Arizona, and walked for 2 weeks with this on my back down through all these canyons looking for the right place to put it back. In one sense, I was pushing against the tide of all these artifacts that are coming out, of the millions and millions of objects that are disappearing from the land. I was putting one back in and just pushing against that. But at the same time, I immediately started questioning what I was doing, because I thought, oh, you're just doing what everybody else has done. You're stealing it because you think you know the right thing to do with it.
And where did you finally put it?
I climbed up this cliff face where there was a little tiny cave, alcove about the size of a bread loaf, just a little hole in the cliff, and I slid the vessel into it and set it back there where I don't think people will find it for centuries.
The moment at which you place it in that little alcove, you're there, your hand leaves the thing. What are you thinking at that point?
I'm thinking, if anybody else finds this, they will see the masking tape, and this will really confound them.
Thanks to Robert Krolwich and Jada Boomrod
from Radiolab
for helping out with this piece.
You're welcome.
If you haven't yet heard the collection of Radiolab episodes this video is a companion to, head over to radiolab.org and look for the Things, Skull, and Kilogram episodes. There's also a short audio story I put together while visiting the Radiolab team in New York.